Hello, and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. I hope you're having a good Monday, and I'm glad you're back for day two of my 25 days of art this month leading up to Christmas. The track you're listening to is O Come All Ye Faithful, and you'll understand why in a minute. But first, if you're new here, I'd love it if you would subscribe and ring the bell for notifications. Normally, I upload twice a week at minimum, Tuesdays and Thursdays, with bonuses some weeks. I am doing 25 days of Christmas and other holiday-related artwork up to and including Christmas Day this month, and then my channel will be on vacation over New Year's. I may have a scheduled upload on Thursday, January 2nd, if I can get enough other footage together after finishing this month's projects. But officially, after Christmas, my channel will be back on Thursday, January 9th. And either way, there will definitely not be a video on the 7th, as I'll be traveling that day. If you like this video, don't forget to hit like and leave a comment down below. I really do appreciate the interaction, as it does help a lot with YouTube's algorithm. I love reading everybody's comments, and I do reply to everyone. When I was in the 4th grade, I had the opportunity to join my school's junior bell choir, and I continued with them and later the senior bell choir all the way through into 9th grade. The artwork I'm creating in the time-lapse footage you're watching right now is a generic handbell, probably an octave 5 or so, right in the middle. They're typically brass bells with a rubber-rimmed clapper and black handles. Handbells that are well taken care of and polished are very reflective, so I'm putting in streaks of Christmassy colors as if the room the bell is sitting in is decorated for Christmas and it's reflecting the colors of the decorations. Each bell is a single note and C5 is the note middle C. The lower numbers are the bass clef and obviously those bells get much bigger. The higher numbers are the treble clef and naturally they get much smaller. True notes, sharps, and flats are all their own notes. Basically, every key on a piano translates to an individual bell in a full set of bells. Most of the bells are rung with one hand. You hold them upright in your fist like an ice cream cone if you're only holding one in each hand. You keep it against your chest when not ringing it, and you ring forward with a slight downward flick as you extend your arm, then arc upward as you bring it back to your chest. To get a staccato note, you dampen the bell by placing your thumb up onto the brass of the bell as you ring it. To get a trill, you shake the bell as you ring it forward. To get a whoop whoop sound in the note, which is marked on the sheet music with symbols that look like a capital letter U, you make side-to-side circles with the bell after you've rung it. Large bell choirs and junior bell choirs may have chimes as well or instead of the bells, and these are rung the same way. Choir chimes are rectangular metal tubes with a felt-rimmed clapper on the top surface. We typically trained our new members by having them shadow a bell player but playing the same notes on the chimes. You might have noticed I specified the way you hold the bell and ring forward if you're only holding one bell in your hand. I said it that way because that's not the only option. The very large bass clef bells are quite heavy, so a common alternate way to play those bells is to have them laying on their side on a padded tabletop and hit them with xylophone mallets. Any size bell can be played in a similar way by hanging them on a rack known as a bell tree. On the other end of the musical staff, with the smaller treble clef bells, you can actually hold 2, 3, or even 4 bells in each hand at once. In this case, you have to flick your wrists at different angles to ring the correct bell and not accidentally ring one of the others. This is most common in fast-paced scores like canon, when the entire upper octave is played by one person. Yes, I've done that, it was awesome. When I was in 7th grade, we had the opportunity to play with an orchestra as part of a Christmas opera performance in downtown Vancouver. It was such an amazing opportunity, and it's such a special memory for me that one of the first things I made sure to go see when I brought my husband home to BC for the first time was to take him to the cathedral we performed at. We lucked out and it was open to go in and look around. I doubt I'll have time at this point to dig out the photos, but when we went back there, I took a panoramic shot of all the stained glass windows in the sanctuary. Back when we actually did that performance, we got to miss a day of school for the Friday matinee, and we stayed at the Sheraton Hotel near the church, which I thought was so fancy and amazing at the time. The thing I remember most about the show itself wasn't our bits performing, but one of the bits on stage. The opera was called Noah's Flood, which of course is the story of Noah's Ark, and when the animals are being rounded up and put onto the Ark, there was a short number dedicated to the doves. There was a pair of ballerinas in white dancing on point as doves, and I remember being so fascinated by how accurately their movements looked like doves, both flying and walking. Another big performance we did was our own annual Christmas concert, which we did in partnership with another school district's bell choir. I think our conductors were friends, and that's why it was always those two particular choirs together. Every year we started the show with a procession of both choirs into the church sanctuary, up the middle aisle to the stage area. One choir on the left and one choir on the right, everyone standing beside someone who was ringing the same notes, and we walked in playing O Come All Ye Faithful. By the time the song was finished, we were all arranged around the bell tables on the stage, alternating choir A, choir B, all the way up the octaves. When that song was done, then one choir would sit down and let the other choir play their set, then switch. Then we did the same big procession out. I honestly can't remember if the procession out was the same song every year, and whether or not it was also O Come All Ye Faithful, or if we picked something different. I actually looked at a bunch of bell choir sheet music collections online before typing up my voiceover script for this video, just to see if any Christmas song titles jumped out, because I wasn't even completely sure the procession in was O Come All Ye Faithful. It's been over a decade, okay? But only that one really jumped out, so I'm going with it. We played O Come All Ye Faithful on the way in, and I don't remember what we played on the way out. Naturally, we also played at school assemblies, and we usually had a spring concert, just our choir, at a different local church. You might think it would make sense if we had performed alongside the school's voice choir or the grade 7 band, but keep in mind, the bell choir was an extracurricular activity and so was the voice choir, so there was always an overlap in members. In the case of 7th graders, often in all three. I'm specifying 7th graders because that school was kindergarten to grade 7, and 7th grade was when band started. We did K to 7 in one school and then 8 to 12 in our high school, and in grade 7 they started trying to transition us to the whole block schedule thing. So the different grade 7 teachers would take on different subjects they specialized in and swapped classrooms, so we had all the grade 7 teachers instead of just one. And then we had an arts block where we signed up for either band, drama, or fine arts, and went to the appropriate room during that period. Believe it or not, I did band, not fine arts. I played B-flat clarinet, because that's what Mom had done when she was in high school, so that's the band instrument we already owned. I wanted to play piccolo. How about you? Any chance any of you were ever part of a bell choir? If not, how many of you were in the school band, and what instrument did you play? I'd love to hear all about it in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back tomorrow with a brand new No Box Art Box episode. Bye guys!